The purpose of this tutorial is to explain the differences between RSS and CPS, discuss the hardware required to program a radio, discuss the ways in which data can be read and written to the radio, make the student familiar with the layout of the CPS, discuss some of the configuration windows within the CPS, discuss the encoder and decoder definitions, and explain the reason for common errors and how to remove or ignore them. At the end of this tutorial, the student will be able to know about and be able to use the relevant hardware to program a radio, explain the purpose of most configuration windows. Until the mid-1990s, all Motorola radios were programmed by means of RSS, radio server software. With the advent of Microsoft Windows, users needed RSS to run on this operating system. Also, many users did not need the alignment functions present in the RSS. As a result of user feedback, Motorola developed and released CPS. CPS is an acronym for Customer Programming Software. As the name suggests, it is used to program the features and functions in Motorola radios. Some facts about CPS and radios. The configuration data in a radio is called a code plug. The code plug can be saved on your PC as a .cpg file. When a radio is read using the CPS, a copy of the radio's configuration is made in the PC memory or RAM. The changes are made to the copy in memory and should either be saved or written to the radio. During the read or write process, the CPS will communicate with the radio to ensure A, that the radio which is connected is a valid type, B, the data is received with no errors, and C, the radio is in a condition to receive the data. CPS purchased through the EMEA sales region can only program radios sold in the EMEA region. Radios from other regions will not work with the EMEA CPS. In order to program the professional series radios, the following Motorola items are needed. Alternatively, the following cables can be used. In this case, the RIB is not needed, but alignment and testing of the radio will not be possible. To install the CPS is supplied on a CD which can be ordered from Motorola. To install the CPS, simply insert the CD into the CD-ROM drive of your PC and wait for the installation to start. Then, follow the installation instructions. The CPS icon will be placed on the Start menu under Motorola. The File menu contains commands for reading data from a radio, writing data to a radio, and opening a recently used file. Note that the write command is only available if a code. To open a code plug, click File and Open. You can choose where the code plug is located. Click once on the file to view the information and twice to open. Clicking on the connector symbol next to any tag will expand the information within that tag. Clicking on any green tag will open that window. For example, clicking on the radio information tag will open the radio's information window. This shows all the information about the radio or file, such as serial number, model number, and other related information. The CPS contains a number of fields. Let's look at some of these. Firstly, we have button definitions. This defines how the buttons are used. Secondly, alerts, miscellaneous, signaling definition, menu item, if the radio has a displaying keypad, RF. Here we can program the scan function. In here we would specify how the radio works in emergency mode, GPIO lines on the mobile radio, contact list, status decode and status encode, configuration bytes, only change these if told to do so by Motorola, per channel, per personality, and here we have the encoder and decoder definitions. More about this in the next slide. Signaling system definitions is where we can define how the radio sends signaling. Refer to the CPS tutorial reference manual for a detailed description of each configuration window within the CPS. Encoders and decoders. The CPS contains windows for encode and decode. These windows contain configuration settings for the Select 5 signaling. The encoder windows contain configuration settings used when the radio sends Select 5 signals. The decoder windows contain configuration settings used to specify what the radio should do if a particular sequence is received. For example, let's have a look at encoder sequences. Here we have a number of fields. The first one of interest is sequence. In here we can specify any numbers between 0 and 9, B, C, D, F, and variable address and status digits. The length, the maximum length of the sequence can be up to 12 digits. Note that variable digits are contained within brackets. Be careful not to leave this field blank. The next field which is of interest is pre-time. This is the time from which the radio will begin to transmit until the time that the radio sends the first tone in the sequence. This is adjustable between 0 and 2550 milliseconds or 2.5 seconds. Remember that this field must correlate with the sequence timeout value, which is under per radio signaling definition. The encoder configuration window specifies what the radio should do to send Select 5 signals. The sequence is the actual sequence which will be sent. The sequence can consist of any digits from 0 to 9 and letters B, C, D and F. The sequence can also contain variable digits contained within brackets. These variable digits are A1 to A8, S1 to S3, and T1 and T2. The sequence cannot be left blank. Variable digits are only allowed in radios with display. The encoder configuration window specifies what the radio should do to send Select 5 signals. The pre-time is the amount of time taken before the first digit of the sequence is sent. The pre-time of the first sequence in the telegram must match the sequence timeout value in the signaling definition window under per radio. A sequence can only be sent as a telegram. Up to 3 sequences can be sent together as a telegram. here, what we're going to do is we're going to add four sequences. These four sequences can be sent together or by themselves in the encoder telegram. Encoder sequence number 1 refers to encoder sequence 1, and encoder sequence number 2 refers to the second sequence which is sent. Let's have a look at this again. So encoder sequence 1 sends sequence 1, the second sequence will be sequence 2. If we want to send the sequence and we expect an acknowledge, we would select acknowledge and we would select one of the options, acknowledge expected. In encoder telegram 2, we're going to send sequence 3 and sequence 4. Telegrams are used to send sequences. A telegram can contain 1, 2, 3 sequences. An acknowledgement can be required by the radio. In such a case, choose from one of the acknowledge options from the acknowledge drop-down. To send a telegram can be sent under the following conditions. 1. As an automatic acknowledgement to a telegram received from another radio. 2. By pressing one of the buttons on the radio. 3. As an authorization request from a radio. 4. Pressing the PTT, in other words, PTT ID. Almost all of these can be configured in the personality window. Here, we would specify the PTT ID. PTT key up mode refers to the telegram which is sent at the beginning of transmission. And PTT dkey encode refers to the telegram which is sent at the end of transmission. Call 1, in this case, sends telegram number 1. There are a number of telegrams to choose from. These relate to the telegrams in our encoder definitions. Here, call 2 can send telegram 2. There are 4 call buttons. The call buttons refer to the buttons on the side of the radio. In this case, side button 2 sends call 1 and side button 3 sends call 2. Decoders. The radio can be configured to take a certain action when it receives a certain sequence. The sequence can consist of digits 0 to 9, B, C, D, and F, as well as variable digits A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, right through to A8, and status digits S1 to S3. T1 and T2 are used to specify non-standard tones. A decoder can consist of up to 3 sequences. There are a number of actions the decoder can take when receiving a sequence. These are described in the next slide. Decoder definitions. Decoder sequence. Number of sequences. If we select either 1, 2, or 3, you will see that decoder sequence 1, 2, or 3 become ungrayed. In our decoder sequence, we can specify any digits 0 to 9, plus B, C, D, and F, and we can specify variable digits A1 through to A8, and status digits S1 to S3. The tick box under group sequence, these ticks refer to the positions in which the group tone will be received. Tick any of the positions which specify where the group tone will be received. Under Decoder Options 1, there are a number of options for decoder type. Incoming emergency will make the radio alert when there is an incoming emergency. Priority indicates a priority call. Emergency exit will cause the radio to stop emergency mode. Stun will cause the radio to stop operating. Unstun will cause the radio to operate once it's received the unstun code. Clear down will cause the radio to clear a call down. Silent interrogate will cause the radio to send an acknowledgement without the user's knowledge. Acknowledge one ringing will cause the radio to ring when it receives an acknowledge. ACK1 authorization will cause the radio to alert that an authorization acknowledge has been received. There are a number of types of alerts, individual, ringing, and priority. This will cause the radio to sound an alert according to that setting. Call reminder alert, call reminder LED will cause the radio to remind the user that a call was received. Auto reset start will cause the radio to start the auto reset timer. Call answer timer will give the user a predetermined time in which to answer the call, and call back will allow the user to automatically call back the calling radio if they've missed the call. Auto acknowledge will cause the radio to send an acknowledgement when it receives this particular sequence, and call forward acknowledge will cause the radio to send a call forward message to another radio. Auto reset timer. The purpose of the auto reset timer is to force the radio to return to its previous squelch condition after it has received a selective call. The following slide shows how this would be used. Firstly, we would set the squelch of the radio, RX squelch mode, to tone squelch. This will mean that the radio will only receive audio if a selective call has been received. There are a number of conditions for auto reset mode. Disabled. Carrier override will mean that the auto reset timer will only start counting when the channel is clear. Carrier independent, the auto reset timer will start counting irrespective of a signal is present on the channel or not. Manual override means that the user has to override the auto reset timer. The auto reset timer can be specified in this field: per radio, RF, RX, auto reset time. And this is a field from 1 to 60 seconds in steps of 1 second. Errors and warnings. When writing a code plug to the radio or saving a code plug, the CPS may display one or more errors or warnings. A warning indicates that one or more fields will result in undesired operation in the radio. You can still write or save the code plug, but you will first need to check these warnings. An error indicates that a field has been set to an invalid value. You will need to correct this before saving or writing this code plug. An invalid field error can also be displayed. In this case, the field has been set to an invalid value, or usually means that it's blank, and needs to be corrected before writing or saving. You can click on the invalid value and the CPS will take you to that location. In conclusion, the purpose of this tutorial is merely intended to show you the CPS and to give you some idea about its layout. Please read the CPS reference guide and watch the video entitled Select 5 Signaling Tutorial included with this course material. Examples of programming will be shown in the classroom. Please remember to bring your PC and programming cables to the class.